Hi, I'm Paul. I'm one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. In this video, we're going to go over what a competitive market is, their characteristics, and some examples of what is and what is not a competitive market. A competitive market space is one where firms are efficiently meeting consumer demand, and no one firm has an outsized influence on price or quantity. Economists categorize these market structures into four broad categories, organized from most competitive to least competitive. Perfect competition is the most competitive. In a perfectly competitive market, suppliers produce products that are basically identical from one another, and no firm controls the market share. Products sold are perfectly substitutable, and there is no innovation on the supply side or economies of scale that could benefit one producer. Investment in marketing and branding expenditures eventually offer no upside. Barriers to entry and exit are basically zero, which means firms can leave and enter the industry without any different costs. Prices are highly elastic and firms are price takers. Consumers benefit from the lowest prices compared to other market structures and can maximize their demand. The amount of output and prices are the most efficient from the consumer perspective in comparison to other market structures, and consumers can maximize their demand. Perfect competition does not exist in the real world, but they offer a useful thought experiment in order to learn the concept of different market structures. Now, let's take a look at monopolistic competition. Monopolistic competition occurs when a number of firms offer a very similar product that are not perfectly substitutable and a little bit distinguishable from one firm to another. Thus, since each firm produces a product that is a little different than the other, they're considered their own monopoly, hence the term monopolistic competition. In monopolistic competition, suppliers focus on marketing and price strategies in order to maximize the products sold. Products are substitutable, but to a lesser degree than perfect competition. Barriers to entry and exit are still very, very low, and firms can enter and exit an industry basically with zero cost. Prices are still highly elastic, but consumers are influenced by branding and marketing from one product to another. Consumers still benefit from competition from firms, but marketing and branding are the main avenues of price and output competition between one firm or another. Examples of monopolistic competition exist in real life. Think about the low-cost household items that you can see in various pharmacies, drugstores, or everyday goods. Now, let's take a look at an oligopoly. An oligopoly is a market structure where few firms control the industry, but the goods that are supplied within the firms are basically perfectly substitutable. Suppliers are profit-maximizing and collude with the other firms in such an industry to set prices. Such a set of firms are called cartels. These products made in the industry may be perfectly substitutable from one another, but together and outside the industry and outside this cartel, they're very, very hard to replicate outside the oligopoly. In an oligopoly, barriers to entry and exit are high outside the cartels, further limiting competition. Prices are more inelastic, and firms may focus more on innovation and economies of scale that reduce the costs of production. In an oligopolistic environment, consumers are now price takers and would consume less than they would in a perfectly competitive environment. The Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, OPEC, is sometimes considered an oligopoly, given the dominance of a few suppliers who interact with one another to set the production of oil. Finally, on the least competitive type of market structure is the monopoly. Monopolies have key different features. Barriers to entry and exit are extremely high, preventing competition. Consumers are therefore price takers, and demand is inelastic since the particular product is demanded and not easily replicated by another firm or another industry. An example of a particular economy could be a drug company that has a life-saving drug and its process of manufacture is protected by intellectual property.
Thank you for watching. If you still have questions, come visit Chegg, where you can interact directly with one of our Chegg subject matter experts.